the question of whether to go straight to mild or perform an epidurogram or an epidural steroid injection really relies on the patient's sort of history. If they come from a practice where they've, you know, had several epidurals and, you know, had failure efficacy, there's no reason to go do one more. So those patients that come to my practice, we discuss, you know, an alternative therapy which they're excited about. In terms of if a patient hasn't had an epidural steroid injection and I think it'll benefit them, and over, you know, they haven't had an ESI in over a year, you know, I'll discuss with them that we'll do one, and if they get over a month, they can decide whether or not they want to repeat it, or we can go straight forward to a definitive therapy. So I think moving straight to mild for a patient who has already shown failure of ESIs is the perfect, you know, way to approach a patient who comes to you from another practice or has had history of epidural steroid injections. And if a patient hasn't, then I think it's worthwhile, especially if they have, you know, any other components that are inflammatory, radicular, you know, to that nature, to offer them a, you know, a chance to see what it's like. But, you know, I always tell patients that no longer are we doing series of three. You know, we'll evaluate, you know, quickly 2 to 3 weeks after your first initial ESI to decide the next steps.